Hello again, everybody. We're back. This is your friend Will, the Memory Lapse, and we're going into round four of this competitive constructed event with Blue Black Control, a deck list from the top eight of GP Pittsburgh a few weeks ago. And we are 3-0 now. We beat Black Green Tokens, Mono Red, and Red Black. Our Red Black opponent had a pretty spirited game one. Against us, and then kept a one-lander game two and never found the second one, and scooped pretty promptly, so that was a short video. But still, I hope you enjoyed the first game of it, at least. Going into round three here, or round four here, hoping to keep the wins coming. We need all the gold we can get for M19. This looks like a very keepable hand. I think this hand lines up really well against a slow or fast deck. Just the search makes it good against any kind of other control deck. Oh. Definitely keeping. We have all our colors, and this is awesome for us. They don't have a turn one play. So we'll leave with the pools. And it's blue-white control, is my guess. So let's just try to jam the search here and hope they don't have negate or syncopate. They have syncopate. This is going to be really hard for us. We have a lot of dead cards game one. Like, a lot of dead cards game one. And we've drawn some number of them here. This allows a good one, though. Wow, they're just jamming it. Alright, so we'll syncopate back here. I wonder why they would do that. Knowing that we're blue-black, they must know we have a ton of dead cards. Though, game one, they probably have a lot of dead cards as well. Unfortunately, we've drawn so many of them. The game just passes back. Ugh. I have to turn on full control so it doesn't do that. They have approach. I want to syncopate this so we don't have to fight over the next one. So they probably only play one or two of these. And removing it seems pretty good. We have Glimmer at the end of their turn here. See if they waste a counter on this. I mean, if they do, I think we're fine, because it's one less counter they have for the next time we have to counter spell each other. play. Discard a Fatal Push. They're stuck on 8, so they can't really win a fight. We need to resolve that and try to contempt it. Do we have to contempt it now? We have to try to contempt it at some point. So we're 2 land drops away from having a double disallow and Brass's Contempt, so I think we just keep going. So I think what we're going to do here... Ugh, we need one more mana. Alright, we just gotta take this. We're not in a rush, so let's not get greedy. Because we're going to have to make a play to get Gear Hulk resolved. We need one more land. Oh, it doesn't do it. But that, at least it's redundant, so... We need to do this once now, and hopefully we draw a land next turn. Their hand is loaded. They haven't made a land drop in a while. Oh, did it just crash? Looks like it did. Yep. Yep. I just restarted the computer and everything. Okay, let's go. These assets. Wow, at least it loaded back in really quick. That's nice. So hopefully it should be on. Their end of turn. Okay, perfect. So. Timeout used. Yeah, very fair. 3, 4, 5, 6. Gear Hulk. And I expect they'll try to counter this. Which we're going to let happen. Yep. Yeah, we still missed our land drop. Any of these few turns, we needed to hit a land pretty badly. Yeah, that's really brutal. think we're just gonna do this here, though. They just used a cancel on this. Negate, they have a negate. Resolve. We're under the threat of like a second sunrise coming. I think we try to counter this. We just lost this one. We missed too many land drops, unfortunately, and we drew literally every fatal push in our deck. But games 2 and 3, I think we'll be much better positioned. All right, there's a land. That's exactly what we needed. They have another counterspell here. They got us. We just never had the mana to make plays with the Vraska's Contempt and the Vraska's Contempt and the Disallows, because we just missed that land drop. If we still had the Vraska's Contempt in play, now we have enough. No, wait, do we have enough? 4, 3. No, we still don't. We're still one land short, but our opponent has so much land in play. Surely they have something here. Yep, negate. Alright, so that's game one. We actually lose to this Gideon, because we just couldn't draw land for the 5 turns that it clocked us. But now we get a lot of sideboards, which is awesome. Take out the fatal pushes. Bring in Bloodfast. Bring in Doomfall. Bring in Eldest Reborn, bring in both negates, bring in Spyglass, bring in Commit. Take out Cast Down. I think we need to keep the Vraska's Contempt. We can shave a Scarab God because it doesn't do very much. Keeping in 2 Essence Scatters, which I think is decent coverage in case they do bring in creatures. It's certainly possible. Alright. Oh no, what am I thinking? We have these Duresses. Okay, so out Essence Scatter. And we need the blink. I don't know, it's decent. Maybe we only need one commit. Let's do that. This is a nice one. They're not going to be able to do anything about this Bloodfast. Cool, so let's just jam this. I don't think they have anything that they can punish us with on turn 2. And we can save this Spyglass for like turn 5. to try to snipe Teferi. There's no way they brought in like Spell Pierce, right? I think the worst they can do here is search for Skanta. Treasure map. That's okay. No rush to duress here. We can wait until like turn 6 to duress and try to pluck the pluck something out of their hand, like an approach. We'd rather, I think, hold up Syncopate and draw a card if we don't, if we're not forced to use it. This will hopefully ensure that we keep the land coming all game. If we can outland them and outresource them, it should be pretty easy to find a win. A land drop already. Oh, they stepped away, I guess. Great draw. Both great draws. I wonder if it's worth duressing here. Now that they have enough mana, I think we duress next turn. Duress or we Spyglass next turn, or both. Oh, no, no, thank you. We want to keep this. This is a good one. Alright, with that negate. Oh, these are great draws. Okay. I think we're going to duress first. So they brought in Gearhulks. I guess we get rid of the Syncopate. So they don't get value off of the Gearhulk with it. I thought we were going to draw all these cards and miss a land drop all of a sudden. So we get to sit back here, As long as we don't turn on their cancels, they're never going to want to play this Gear Hulk. Gideon. Don't think we want to lose to Gideon again. They drew their own negate. I guess we'll disallow. Keeps us off of drawing this turn, but it keeps the Gideon out of play. Now they do get some value out of this Gear Hulk, which is annoying. Yeah, I think we're just sitting back and drawing this turn. Don't see a lot of value in dressing one of the cancels. Nice, found our land drop. Maybe now we do want to do this. Get these cancels out of hand. They don't have six, so they can't play the Gear Hulk. Oh, Seal Away's dead. Maybe we even Spyglass. The treasure map so they can't flip it here. I like that. So now they have that active. I think we're going to go for Glimmer here. And if they try to put in the Hulk, we're just going to disallow it. This is a fairly good Hulk bait for them. We're on 10. These are both good. So it seems like they're more or less on air here. The Seal Away won't be too hard to play around. I mean, honestly, it'll be great against the Gear Hulk because we'll get to commit it and or blink it. Were they trying to activate the treasure map, maybe? digging to an answer, a win condition here. Trying to craft a hand that will be able to answer any of their threats. Let's see. I wonder how many Gear Hulks they have. I would guess they only have like 2 or 3 in the sideboard, not the full 4. So let's see, Teferi. We'll negate that. If they have an answer, we'll syncopate it. We still want to draw a little bit here. Two times. I think we don't want to go down below this. Oh, Cure Hulk. This does everything that we need it to do. I think it's worth it to negate this or disallow this. Don't want to let them activate their treasure map and flip it. We do want to flip our search. To attack into Seal Away. Oh. That's fine. That's fine. And I do think we're just going to jam Gear Hulk here to draw. Oh, did they draw a counterspell? Oh, they paid for this poorly. Oh, but we still don't have enough. Okay. I guess that was greedy on our part. I wonder why they did that when they had the Seal Away. I think what I did is I missequenced there. I should have played the Gear Hulk first and the Escalante second to play around exactly that. Nope. Not add blue. Add a card to my hand, please. Another search. I think that's good. I guess we'll Doomfall. See what the other card is. Whatever it is, it's not a land. So they would definitely be playing them right now. Nezahal. Yikes. Why didn't they play that? I guess they were trying to build up a hand to protect it. Alright, so they did bring in creatures. They might have even sided out the, sided out all of their approaches. Oh, nice. We're just gonna play this to get to Teferi. Alright, yep. We have 7 cards and all the land. So knowing that they'd made those little changes, I think we want the Essence Scatters. Is there a cheaper way? Yeah, I don't think we want the Scarab Gods at all. Do we? No, maybe we do, knowing that they have... Do we cut the blink? They have some enchantment removal, so the blink could be good to get something out from under blink. Maybe we cut commit. The memory does seem like it could be good in the long game here. I think these are most likely just like dead cards. Other than this, yeah, 2 Essence Scatters is okay. Just for the Gear Hulks. Maybe we just want 1 Essence Scatter, because we can't counter the Nezahal, and we'll keep 1 Scarab God. This is much better. I think we even keep this. Search is very good, so we pretty much have to try to get it into play. It eats a syncopator and a gate. We'll just go for it again next turn. Alright, no Gideon, which is awesome for us. And yeah, I think we pretty much just have to go for this again. This is excellent. There's a chance that they're going to cast it out or do something, but... Oh, they're cycling cast out. They might be land blight. Like, they played this Meandering River then. Yeah. So their budget land base is kind of impeding them here. More than kind of. Like, it absolutely is. So now we get to ditch any lands that we don't want. Like, this one goes to the graveyard. sit back on disallow here. Oh, I guess I could have disallowed that Evolving Wilds trigger, but don't think it's worth. Recycling this again. They're letting me keep the search in play. That we want. So they can't go for Teferi or anything here, because they don't have the mana to back it up. So, but we can go for Glimmer. And if they want to spend a counterspell on Glimmer, that's totally fine, because we have a search in play. And then it's one less counterspell that they have to fight over something that's going to win the game. Wow, they actually choose to cancel it. So we'll just run the same thing back here. So we'll keep this Glimmer. Make our land drop. This we can let them have. Don't want to fight over that. Looks like they missed land. I think we want both of these. Don't want that. I'm feeling really good about our position. We're a few cards behind. But that's because they're missing land drops and we're not. And I think from a control versus control standpoint, having the land drops in hand is much preferred. So syncopate is going to get worse over the course of the game. So we'll use this here. Syncopate for two. We should use it now while they're low on lands anyways. Looks like we're going to get to play this Hieroglyphics. It's going to catch us up. Seven cards, so we can flip this search now, which is dope. Graveyard, transform, draw. Land, we can look to cycle this Fetid Pools. And now we have an Escanta active, which is incredible in terms of finding answers. Let's do this. And then we'll activate Escanta. Seems like they're not playing Escanta or anything. Disallow is more flexible. So at this rate, we're drawing two cards a turn fairly easily. So hopefully we have this locked up. I do think it seems like they've taken the approaches out of their deck. I think we don't have to worry about getting approached out. It would be great to hit a duress or something, so we know that for sure. We have not really encountered any of our sideboard cards here. And there we go. We've seen so many cards, it was like about time, right? Let's see what they got. This chance just gets negated. But I really just want to see their hand and start playing with information. Wow. So they did keep approach. River's Rebuke, which does nothing. Gale Strike does nothing. Pull. Approach. Essence Scatter. I think we let them keep the approach. And we take the pull. Here. Pull, I think, is the only thing that gets them back in this game. Take Essence Scatter here. I like Essence Scatter because it lets us fight over their Gear Hulk. Duress, I don't think, does too much against this hand. They have a lot of dead cards. Our hand's just going to get better and better every turn because we're going to Escanta. I wish we had a Planeswalker that we could hit here. Like a good mono blue Planeswalker that we could have sided into. Take Disallow. Keep making land drops, keep using Escanta. Eventually we're going to find a win condition. Activate Escanta. Take the negate. So that we just have like such a stacked hand here. Gear Hulk is nice too. Pretty sure we can discard a Contempt. I wonder if there's any merit in just trying to play this now. I don't think so. I think we just do this. Yeah, and take the Eldritch Reborn. So now that we have Eldritch Reborn, which gets us back there to Teferi, we're going to start trying to fight over Torrential Gear Hulks on their turn, force them to use mana, and then try to find an opening to play Eldritch Reborn. Like, we have, what, 6, 9. They're just playing this, so they don't have to discard. That's totally fine. Well, I probably just better to discard it. But, yeah, here we go. Gear Hulk away. They let that one hit, even. Oh, so it's Glimmer. Oh, I think we want both of those. So they might just bounce it here. Gale Strike. Which is okay. Because now we get to fight. Oh, we're in a combat. So now we get to fight over Eldest Reborn. To discard, darn. I think we're not gonna need this, to be honest. We're gonna get Teferi back and draw so many cards. Go for River Tribute here, I wonder. Oh, they're going for this, so okay. Just Essence Scatter this. We have so little use for this. We still have Gear Hulk mana up, so whatever they're going to try to do with their 3. We don't need to activate Escanta yet. Escanta's done its job, like we just crafted a hand of all the permission in our deck, more or less. Would be nice to have one more duress. One. So now there's one of these top three. So let's actually activate. Yeah. Let's take our duress. This is sick. We know we're drawing it. Reveal it? Okay. So So here's more or less how we're going to win. Just going to steal their win condition. Essence Scatter disallows Supreme Will. Their own Teferi. I guess we want to take the disallow. Because that can actually cancel like the Teferi emblem trigger. Plus one. Draw the Fetid Pool. Cycle. Draw the land that's on top. End turn. Untap two lands. End turn, discard islands. Keep all the gas. Teferi. We'll get met with negate. Supreme Will doesn't help. They're most likely going to use that to dig. Jeez, do they? Where have their lands been this game? They thinned a bunch of Evolving Wilds. Okay, gladly paying three here. Draw the Fetid Pools, we'll just put it into play. Dress is coming up. Maybe we should have cycled for Dress. Untap our lands. So, pretty sure, like, I don't know what they can draw against this. That's going to let them solve the Teferi. And once Teferi goes ult, we'll just take all their permanents out, and then we'll get Torrential Gearhulks down. Win the game pretty quickly, relative to how long this game has taken. Pretty quickly. Might be tempted to go for like a Gearhulk here. I don't know. I don't know why they're still. I guess they're still playing it out because it's competitive constructed. There's prizes on the line. Make me win. Like, I totally get it. But I don't see how they're going to win from this position. So here comes Gearhulk. And we can use one of our three disallows on that. I think they know about all these cards. But even if they resolve an approach, it just really doesn't matter. I guess we'll just take the Essence Scatter. Plus. And we're just going to end the turn. No point in trying to sneak a Gearhulk in or anything. Tap our blue sources. So next turn we're drawing two more lands. Yep, no issue with that. We're going to hold the fetid pool to cycle it. Once we ult Teferi, just to start getting the permanents out faster. Oh, I guess we're going to untap their planes for them, that's fine. And discard our blink. No, let's discard the Brassless Contempt. The blink also works nicely with Teferi next turn. Deck out. So we're going to draw a Syncopate. Alright. So, -8. Start by getting rid of the treasure map. Oh, we got plenty of time here. And we'll start just trying to jam Gear Hulks on their turn. We're even going to discard the Gear Hulk here. Because we're going to memory, probably, to like, once we get them down below a certain number of permanents. Once we nail their blue sources, they really have no outs at all. Don't want to attack into the seal away. I was worried they had like some move, like some way to mill me. Like if they had their own new rivulet, that would be pretty bad. But I guess they saw which way this was going. Yeah, so very good. Came back pretty easily on that one. Got one of our packs. Let's go check it out. Hey, Traxos, nice. Traxxas is going to be interesting in the new set, I think. So good to have another one of those. And so where are we at? We're 4-0 in this. Played against 4 different decks, which is really cool. That was a long one. That went on for an hour. So we're going to call it here. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching, and hope you all enjoyed.